your experience as a community organizer. I wonder what your reaction is to that, but also, how is community organizing relevant experience for the presidency?
This is very curious. So this is work I did 3 years ago. They haven't talked about the fact that I was a civil rights lawyer. They haven't talked about the fact that I taught constitutional law. They haven't talked about my work in the state legislature, the United States Senate. They're talking about the 3 years of work that I did right out of college, as if that's I'm making the leap from 2 or 3 years out of college into the presidency. So, look, I would argue that doing work in the community to try to create jobs, to bring people together, to rejuvenate communities that had fallen on hard times, to set up job training programs in areas that had been hard hit when the steel plants closed, that's relevant only in understanding where I'm coming from, who I believe in, who I'm fighting for, and why I'm in this race. And the question I have for them is, why would that kind of work be ridiculous? Who are they fighting for? What are they advocating for? Do they think that the lives of those folks who are struggling each and every day, that working with them to try to improve their lives is somehow not relevant to the presidency? I think maybe that's the problem. That's part of why they're out of touch and they don't get it, because they haven't spent much time working on behalf of those folks.
There's been a lot of pushback from Republicans that a lot of the coverage from the media and also response from Democrats, including from your campaign, has to Governor Palin's appointment has been sexist, that it's been dismissive of the work she's done and it has acted in ways that they would not deal with a male running mate. Do you have any response?
Listen, I mean, if they want to work the refs, they are free to do so. And I think the public can make their judgments about this. You know, the notion that any questions about her work in Alaska is somehow not relevant to her potentially being vice president of the United States doesn't make too much sense to me. I think she's got a compelling story, but I assume that she wants to be treated the same way that guys want to be treated, which means that their records are under scrutiny. I've been through this for 19 months. She's been through it, what, 4 days so far?
Senator, some Democrats have expressed concern that your campaign and you specifically are not engaging her enough and criticizing her enough. Is that a concern of yours, or why are you taking sort of a hands-off approach and focus on Senator McCain?
So John McCain's running for president. I'm running against John McCain. And as far as I can tell, I don't get a sense that Governor Palin has ideas that are different from John McCain's. And that speech that she delivered was on behalf of John McCain. And the essential question in this campaign is, who's got a better plan, a better agenda to move this country forward and fundamentally change it from the economic and foreign policy failures that we've seen over the last 8 years? I believe that the American people need change, they want change, and I'm in the best position to bring it on a whole host of issues, from energy to health care to education. And if at some point Senator McCain actually addresses those issues, then I think that's going to be a useful debate for the American people to listen to.
Strategy change at all now that after not only Governor Palin but also Giuliani, several other speakers sort of went on the attack? Does your strategy change? Do you have to go more on the attack now?
What do you guys expect? Right? I mean, I anticipated this last Thursday in my acceptance speech. This is what they do. They don't have an agenda to run on. They haven't offered a single concrete idea so far in two nights about how they would make the lives of middle-class Americans better. They've spent the entire two nights attacking me or extolling John McCain's biography, which is fine. They can use their convention time any way they want, but yeah, you can't expect that I'd be surprised about attacks from Republicans. And by the way, I mean, I've been called worse on the basketball court. It's not that big of a deal.
Were you surprised by the choice of Palin, and does it change the way that you look at the race at all, given it's such an unconventional choice?
I think ultimately this race is going to be about myself and John McCain, and who's in a better position to lead the country to make sure that young people can go to college, people who don't have health care get it, that we're creating jobs here in the United States that pay well and that provide decent benefits and people can retire with dignity and respect, and that we can keep the American people safe and rebuild our standing in the world. That's what this election is going to be about. And, you know, ultimately, all I can say is I'm very proud of my pick, Joe Biden, and I am absolutely confident that he's going to be able to help me govern in a very effective way should I have the honor of being president. All right?
And that is Barack Obama just finishing up in York, Pennsylvania. You're also seeing in part of your screen that is Joe Biden in Manassas, Virginia, in a town hall meeting there. A strong pushback from Barack Obama after Republicans have spent their days here at the Republican National Convention, not only highlighting the career of John McCain, but bashing the Democrats. Obama's rejoinder to Sarah Palin's attack about him just being a community organizer, he said, well, who are they fighting for? Do they think the lives of working Americans are not relevant? I guess he said they haven't spent much time addressing the needs of those folks. We've got a fight on our hands, ladies and gentlemen, between the Republicans and the Democrats. Anybody who thought this campaign was going to be dull is wrong. You can see Biden there, too. One of the other things that has come up, was asked to Biden on the morning shows this morning, is about charges of sexism, which Barack Obama said, look, I bet she wants to be treated the same way as the guys do. Her record will be scrutinized. He said, my record's been scrutinized for 19 months. She's only been out, what, 5 days, he said. In fact, Sarah Palin herself, a couple months ago, was asked about Hillary Clinton when she and her campaign charged sexism. She alluded to Hillary Clinton's claims as whining in an interview with Newsweek magazine. There's a lot of interesting stuff going on, certainly, in this campaign now, as we have got an amazing political race on our hands.